Good morning and welcome to SI Live's AM with Alex. I'm Alex Salmieri. It's Monday. We have a hot day ahead of us. I'm going to start the show out a little differently this week. Since COVID numbers have been consistently down, I'll be giving you guys a roundup once or twice a week with all of the updates. But for now, here are today's top headlines. A heat advisory is in effect on Staten Island until 8 p.m. Tuesday night. The National Weather Service warned of a heat index around 100 degrees during the advisory, with high temperatures and humidity dangerous enough to cause illness. They recommend individuals drink tons of fluids, stay in air-conditioned rooms, stay out of the sun, and check up on relatives and neighbors. In other news, a second stimulus relief package for Americans was confirmed by Senate Leader Mitch McConnell on the Senate floor this week, but the details on the stimulus check and the bill it would include are scarce. After McConnell's speech on Tuesday, U.S. Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin confirmed that the second stimulus check will be the same as the first. McConnell said, speaking on, building on what worked in the CARES Act, we want another round of direct payments to help American families driving our national comeback. In local news, today the Staten Island Zoo in West Brighton officially reopens its doors to the general public after being closed for over 4 months during the height of the ongoing coronavirus pandemic. The zoo and all other outdoor arts and entertainment facilities are only permitted to operate at a 33% capacity for the time being to ensure social distance. Face coverings are required for all zoo guests over the age of 2, with additional hand sanitizer stations installed throughout the premises. All tickets must be reserved ahead of time using the Staten Island Zoo website. And to end the show with some positivity, 5 Staten Island families that lost a loved one to the coronavirus each received a donation of $500 during a ceremony on Sunday at Our Lady of Mount Carmel, St. Benedicta Church in West Brighton. Michelle Molina, Director of Healthcare Initiatives at El Centro del Emigrante, said, "We are very blessed we have doctors and a businesswoman that gathered together funds to support and aid to give some type of relief to these families that have been affected." To learn more about the donations and get more information about all of these stories, visit silive.com. Thank you so much for tuning in. Try to stay cool today, wear your mask, stay safe, and stay tuned for more updates.